agenda ya na yusite.
Asifu ni agenda ya na yusite.
Ni agenda ya makapitale.
Asifu ni agenda ya makapitale. Asifu ni agenda ya makapitale.
Asifu mabaya mulana mabaya.
Asifu ni agenda ya makapitale.
Asifu mabaya mulana mabaya.
Asifu ni
agenda ya makapitale.
I think it's very important for us to be assembling and remembering the slain markers, the slain miners of Marikana, and also the people of Marikana. Before we start with our program, we'd like to ask everyone to please look up. We have the green blanket flying above us. We'd like to take a moment of silence in remembrance of the people of Marikana. Can we please bow our heads? Thank you very much. In our presence, we have Comrade Joseph Mutunja, who is the president of AMPU. And we also have with us Advocate Jim Nichols, who's a UK lawyer, who's one of the lawyers for the families of the Marikana miners. Comrades, just to contextualize his presence, as RMF, our politics are clear, and we want to open up space.
Friends, thank you for having me here. But before I say something about the commission, let me say something about what happens in England. Because there are a lot of people like me. I'm now 70 years of age, and 55 years ago, my father, who was a miner in the north of England, took me on a demonstration that he said was important because he had learned that 69 black people in South Africa had been shot dead by the apartheid police. So you can imagine what a shock it was to me when in August the 16th, 2012, having supported the campaign against apartheid for all of my life, I switched on my television and I saw broadcast live black police officers shooting down poor black miners from an ANC government that I'd supported. It was a tragedy. I found myself coming to South Africa, and I'm proud that I came to South Africa to represent the families of those who were slaughtered and to give advice to AMCU and Joseph Mutunja. Lonmin opted for the cheap option. Break this strike with the help of the police, with the help of Cyril Ramaphosa, with the help of other governments. They chose the cheap option in an attempt to avert a long strike, and shame upon them. These people should be before the courts charged with murder. Because of the consequences of 34 black miners being killed, 14 shot in the back, 4 shot in the back of the head. There is a new slogan that is taking effect throughout the world, a new slogan which I guess is going to be heard also in South Africa, but it forms what is happening inside America, where they're not prepared to take it lying down, where they stand up and say, we're going to fight back, and tens upon tens of thousands of young people take to the streets in Ferguson to fight against the police. And that slogan is, Black Lives Matter! Black Lives Matter! With your support and the magnificent support that I can see all around, and I certainly saw as I came into this university, there will be justice for the people of Marikana. Thank you very much. I learned only one word, it was this, Amandla!
I greet you all, and I'm so much humbled to be invited into this institute, of which I never had an opportunity in my young days to attend to such institution. So therefore, use it into its maximum in order to liberate ourselves as African in Africa. Comrade, the 2012 massacre was a well-planned massacre by the capitalists. We've seen our government, our African National Congress, our beloved movement of history, whereby they sold their own people to the highest bidder of the capitalists. We've got a monopoly of the minerals in South Africa, to be specific, platinum. But the price of platinum is still decided by the, or determined by the masters in New York, in Mercantile Stock Exchange. We don't have a say in these minerals. Our brothers are killed because of the very same minerals. The migrant system was created, was enacted to be a law in 1913, when you talk about the Land Act, where our forefathers were forced to leave their subsistence for farming and be brought to come and mine this gold. And this 1994, we thought it would bring relief to the majority of people of South Africa, but we've seen the individual getting richer and richer in the expense of their black brothers for the majority of the South Africans. Another thing that I need to warn you before I step down, don't love your political party more than South Africa. So there is no investment. It's another level of